news from Indonesia. Indonesian couple each whipped 100 times for premarital sex. Two Indonesians caught having premarital sex were flogged 100 times each in the conservative Aceh province. The couple had their temperatures checked and wore face masks as they were lashed with a rattan cane outside a mosque on the western tip of Sumatra. Aceh is the only region in the Muslim-majority country of Indonesia to impose Islamic law, which allows whipping for charges including gambling, adultery, drinking alcohol, and gay sex.
Okay, so this is, I don't know if people know that, but Aceh is kind of like Indonesia, but behind 1,000 years compared to the rest of Indonesia. But let's just be clear, Indonesia as a whole is going backwards, not just this province. But this province is just going back faster than Indonesia. Like, Islam is a cancer that is infecting more and more Indonesia. Some of the most barbaric laws is making into their, you know, federal overall country, but this province always gets the most attention because of this barbarism. And again, when they say they're getting whipped 100 times, like, this is not, you know, people have fainted over this. Like, this is like extreme torture. Like, this is not like a little twig that they just come in, like,
they
symbolically.
They had to stop halfway through because the man, like, couldn't take it. And then they gave him a break, and then they kept doing it again. And then they had to bring in a second person to whip the woman because, you know.
Yeah.
One person 100 times really takes it out of you. Like, oh, my God.
Yeah. I mean, people pass out halfway through this, which shows how insanely barbaric this is. And what is it? What was the crime? Quote unquote crime here.
Premarital sex.
Jesus, man! Imagine if we were punished for something like this.
In the article, it also mentioned a different case where a man was whipped 40 times for simply being found in a hotel room with a woman. And then the woman didn't get whipped because she was underage, but just being found in a hotel room together got him a punishment of 40 lashes.
Let me remind people that Indonesia is often used by Islamic reformists as how modern and progressive Islam can be, right? This is an example. Malaysia and Indonesia are examples of, look, Islam can't be that bad. Look at Indonesia. So this is the best you can get. This is the best you can expect from an Islamic country, right? Where people are being tortured because of victimless crimes. People who didn't harm anybody are being tortured, right? Under the most modern, most progressive, most liberal Islamic countries in the world, this is what you get, right? So even if you were like, oh, well, Aceh is different than the rest of Indonesia, so you can't judge all of Indonesia based on Aceh. The rest of Indonesia is allowing it, right? The federal government of Indonesia, if it was against this, they should have been sending a fucking army in there and removing these fucking assholes from power in their province. They're allowing it. This is just sitting back and like, yeah, torture our citizens because they had premarital sex. So no, I'm not just going to blame Aceh. I'm going to blame all of Indonesia. Not the people, but the government and the Islamists. Susanna.
So Aceh is able to enforce Kanun law because it has an autonomy deal that was made with the Indonesian government in 2005 that ended like a decades-long separatist insurgency. So
it needs to be liberated by the rest of Indonesia.
Just they for some context.
Yeah, I mean, that's good.
I wanted to mention...
Okay, after
go ahead,
you go and then Rivka after. Go.
Okay, no, what I wanted to mention is like, it's so kind of funny. Like, when they pointed out that, yeah, they're doing all this, the punishment during this pandemic and stuff, the district said that, oh no, we are maintaining proper safety precautions by making the victim wear a mask and maintaining social distancing and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, so I think the victim's main issue would be like he's getting whipped 100 times and still wearing the mask and everything. So this is so like kind of funny to me because the safety precautions while being whipped 100 times on the back. So.
Yeah, I love. They're like, oh, we'll make sure it's coronavirus like proof. We're still going to beat the shit out of you. Damn it. Oh, Chris said in the chat that if no one swore, he was going to give us $10, and I just screwed us.
But I've been, nice job, Susanna.
I've been doing that for a while. Okay, don't worry. Didn't know shit. Okay, Rivka.
I was actually going to echo what I was going to say is exactly what Shipham said. I mean, the whole thing is barbaric, all of it. But
microphone closer, Rivka.
But what really struck me was just this whole, like, but we're taking adequate safety precautions. There were, you know, I just thought that just the irony of that entire little sentence was really informative on how they perceive what they're doing. And yeah, I agree with Shopham. That was something that struck me very much so from this.
I mean, the district is basically, oh, don't worry, we won't let you get corona. But yeah, we'll still whip you 100 times.
Well, and the fact that they checked their temperature, put a face mask on them, and then got the rattan cane and started, you know, I just find that it's actually almost like a Monty Python sketch. You know, the ridiculousness of it.
Right. By the way, I just want to remind people that next time you're fucking before getting married, just appreciate the fact that you are not worried about being tortured for it, okay? This is the time to, you know how they say check your privilege? This is, you know, next time you're actually like having sex with somebody and enjoying it and you're not yet married, just use that time to also appreciate and be like, oh, that might kill the mood, okay? I don't know. But just think about these other people that don't have the privileges that you have. And be like, you might be like, you know what? After I'm done with this, I'm going to go and I'm going to share this article because I just enjoyed a very good, yeah. Anyways, thank you for joining us. Subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell thingy. If you haven't, I don't know why. What's holding you back? Okay. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, why haven't you subscribed to our channel? Explain that to us, please. Like, bell, and also if you're not getting notifications and stuff because YouTube is not telling people that we have shows because YouTube is like, oh, this person told us that they want to get your shows, right? They want to get your videos, but nah, we think it's no. And they also hit the bell button, but nah, you guys are too controversial. We want to show them mainstream stuff. We want to show them CNN or cat videos or whatever. But even there are people are like, no, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, nah, we don't think you want this. We're like, no, please show it to us. We say to you, we want to see Atheist Republic. And YouTube is like, no, we think we know what's better for you than you yourself. So to solve that, there's a link in the description, which is to our newsletter. So hopefully we could email it to you. So hopefully you get some of our content that way. Okay. So yeah. Subscribe to our newsletter as well. And share our videos because, you know, we do get demonetized. That's an obvious on every one of our videos. So F that, but we don't care about that anymore. But we also get deprioritized. And that's even more damaging to us. Deprioritized. What does that mean? That means we don't show up on the suggested, you know, videos on the right and all that, you know, on people's homepages. And that's how channels grow. Unfortunately, we can't grow. So we need you guys to share our videos.